Hello friends, in this video we will see classification of power in detail, where you will be dealing with powers such as P, Q as well as S. What are they? Let's see. Let's start with power classification. Before we start with power classification, we will see what exactly the power is. So you know, power is simply V into I. Suppose if I assume supplied voltage is V of t, because we are dealing with AC signals, V of t is Vm sin omega t. Let's say I of t is simply Im sin of omega t minus phi. So we are assuming that current is lagging voltage by angle phi. Not necessary, it has to be minus phi, we can assume plus phi also. It really doesn't matter for our case. I would say V of t is nothing but instantaneous voltage. Similarly, I of t is nothing but instantaneous current. If instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current is known, we can go for instantaneous power also. That is, V of t will be simply a product of V of t with I of t. I can write P of t as V of t is Vm sin of omega t multiplied by Im sin of omega t minus phi. Or else I can rewrite the equation as P of t as, I can take Vm, Im together. I can write sin omega t into sine of omega t minus phi. What I can do is, I can multiply this with 2 as well as I can divide this by 2. So 2 is getting compensated. The reason why I have done this, because I wanted to apply a formula 2 sine a sine b. So this is, in general, it is 2 sine a sine b. And 2 sine a sine b is nothing but cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. So let's apply the formula. What I get P of t as, it is Vm Im by 2, or in the bracket I can write cos of a minus b first, which is omega t, which is a minus b, which is omega t plus phi, minus cos of a plus b, which will be omega t plus omega t minus phi. Now I can write P of t as Vm Im by 2 cos phi minus cos of 2 omega t minus phi. Is that right? We know the fact that it is very difficult to calculate with instantaneous power, and that's the reason why what we will do is, if the instantaneous power is known to me, I'll go for calculating average power. So, our aim is to go for average power, because it is quite inconvenient to work with instantaneous power. So, our aim is to get average power. See, average power means power over a cycle. If I have to get power, I have to integrate this from 0 to 2 pi. So, let's go on calculating average power now. Average power is simply 1 upon 2 pi integration 0 to 2 pi. It is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi. It is Vm Im by 2 cos phi minus cos of 2 omega t minus phi d omega t. Is that right? In fact, we can actually separate these two integrations, or Vm by Im by 2 is nothing but a constant value, can be taken out only once. In effect, it will become Vm Im by 2 into 1 upon 2 pi. Then we will have two separate integrations, 0 to 2 pi cos phi d omega t minus 0 to 2 pi cos of 2 omega t minus 5 d omega t. Now, what you can see? Cos 5 is actually independent of d omega t. In fact, cos 5 can be taken out, that is as a constant part, where what is remaining in this case is only 1. 1 d omega t integration is simply omega t. What happens at second integration? We will see. At second integration, if you see, it is cos is a function of omega t, and we are actually taking integration with respect to omega t. So, what I can see is it is actually cos integration over a cycle. Please remember, cos integration over a cycle or sine integration over a cycle is always 0. Why? Because suppose if you see sine signal, and if you actually take average value of such sine signal, it is always 0 because positive content and negative contents are equal. Is that right? Whereas in case of cos also this is possible. In case of cos signal also this is possible because as you can see, positive and negative contents are exactly same. So, average over a cycle for cos as well as sine, it is always 0. Irrespective what is phase angle and all, as you can see, you might get confused with this phase angle. You need not to worry about it. Cos integration as well as sine integration are straight away 0 when they are integrated over a period. Why this has not happened for first integration? It is very simple. If you see first integration term, it is cos phi, and cos phi was independent of omega t. In this case, this integration will directly result into 0. So, we can actually reduce this and we can solve further like this. So, P average is now equal to Vm by 2, or in fact, it was Vm Im by 2, 1 upon 2 pi. Cos phi has also come out, 0 to 2 pi integration 1 d omega t. Is that right? It is simply, I can write Vm Im by 2 as Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. I can write 1 upon 2 pi as it is, cos phi as it is, dot. Integration of 1 is simply omega t, which will have lower limit as 0, upper limit as 2 pi. It means it is, I can write Vm by root 2 as Vrms, Im by root 2 as I rms, 1 upon 2 pi as it is, cos phi as it is. As you can see here, if you substitute higher limit minus lower limit, that will give you difference value as 2 pi. Even 2 pi 2 pi will get cancelled. What is remaining is v rms I rms cos phi. As you can see, this is average value. That's the reason why you must have seen formula like this, vi cos phi, as power calculation formula. Of course, the unit is watt. This P average is also called as active power. Since the unit is watt, it is also called as watt power. This is also called as actual power, or it is also called as power dissipated. For all those words, please remember you have to actually get P average value, that is active power, also called as average power, also called as watt power or power dissipated, etc. The unit for this power is watt, right? So, this is the first classification part we have called as active power, sometimes referred as real power also, indicated as P, and it is given as simply VI cos phi. In fact, the unit is watt, and it is power actually dissipated by resistor. When it comes to inductor and capacitor, now we will see, we will just go back to previous slides. I will show you power associated with inductors and capacitors also. If you have seen first term, it is actually Vm Im by 2 cos phi, and the second term was Vm Im by 2 multiplied by cos of 2 omega t minus phi. As you can see, the first term is independent of omega, where second term you can see it is dependent of omega. Therefore, first part indicates actually power dissipated by resistor or power across R, whereas when you go for power in context with L and C, that is actually a second part. It means the total power is actually combination of what? real power as well as imaginary power also. That is power which depends on L and C. That power we are trying to define. Second classification we shall see like this, which is called as reactive power. Also called as imaginary power sometimes, or it is also called as wattless power, indicated as Q. P equal to VI cos phi, similarly Q is simply VI sin phi, and the unit is volt ampere reactive. In short, it is written as VAR, it is volt ampere reactive. Third is called as apparent power, indicated by S. Speciality of apparent power is actually it is combination of P as well as Q together. In general, it is written as S equal to P plus minus JQ. Now this plus minus also matters. If the circuit is inductive, S is P plus JQ. If it is a capacitive circuit, we find S equal to P minus JQ. But whether it is inductive or capacitive, if I have to get magnitude of S, it is under root of P square plus Q square. Is that right? If you remember, P is VI cos phi and Q is VI sin phi. So if I substitute their values, you will get it is simply equal to VI. What you need to replace P with VI cos phi and Q with VI sin phi. Just substitute in the place of P and Q. Just square it out. VI square comes out of the root, becomes VI, and cos square phi plus sin square phi, of course, it becomes 1. Root of 1 is 1. Simply, it is just VI, and the unit is naturally V stands for volt, I stands for ampere. So the unit is simply volt ampere. I'm sure you have understood apparent power also. Apparent power has got alternative formula also. Please remember, it is V into I conjugate. What is V into I conjugate? It means, let's say if V is 20 at an angle of 30 degree, and let's say current is given as 10 at an angle of, let's say 40 degree ampere, this is volt. When we multiply them, then S is equal to 20 at an angle of 30 degree multiplied with 10 at an angle of 40 degree conjugate. When it comes to conjugate, magnitude remains same, only angle gets inverted, meaning plus 40 degree becomes minus 40, minus 40 would have become plus 40. So this is 10 at an angle of minus 40 degree. Effectively, we know when two polar values are multiplied, magnitude gets multiplied, which is 200, and angle gets added. In this case, because minus 40 is there, it becomes 30 minus 40, which comes out to be minus 10 degree. So this is how we calculate S. This is magnitude of S, which is 200. Again, by expanding this or converting into rectangular value, we can convert this in the form of P plus JQ. So you can actually find the value of P as well as value of Q. Such problems we are going to solve in next few videos. I'm sure you have understood the classification of P, Q, and S. Thank you.